Good day everyone. I felt after reading the comments to the video I put out this morning on the 23rd of August that I need to make a follow-up video to make a couple of things clear. It's clear that many people don't watch the video from beginning to end and then spew out comments that make absolutely no sense. So let me try and make something very plain and simple, and I'm going to be as calm while doing this. Anyone should be prepared for anything at any time, anywhere. This is what I teach, and I will not stop teaching it as long as I'm alive. I'll teach this to my kids. I'll teach this to people that ask me questions. This is not rocket science. It's a very simple concept. When a person says that something is going to happen on a specific day, who do they think they are? Really? You know, who of you have heard of the cry wolf scenario? Many of you must have grown up with your parents teaching you about this. For those of you that are not familiar with it, it's when someone says that something is going to happen in a certain way, that the wolf is going to come and eat all of us, and then we all hide away from the wolf, but the wolf doesn't come. So the next time the wolf really comes and you cry, "Wolf, wolf, the wolf is coming," no one is hiding away. And the wolf gets them. This is not a rocket science concept. It's a very simple concept, and I hope you can understand it. Now, when someone tells you long beforehand that on a day, the 23rd of August, certain things are going to happen, the first thing you should think is, why have they chosen a day? How can they know that something's going to happen on a day when it has not happened yet? How can you know this? If you were in the know, you should be able to stop it. And this begs the question, why is that narrative being driven? It's for one simple reason. There is more to the story, a lot more to the story. This is an age-old tactic, and anyone that falls for it is a fool. And it's okay to be a fool. I've been a fool many times in my life. And through being foolish and being a fool, I learn. And I learn from these mistakes, and hopefully I can give you my perspective on things in the world, and you can choose to use it or lose it. It's absolutely your choice. I want to warn you that you should be prepared for anything at any time, anywhere. And most of us are not in that state, and we should try and get there as fast as we can, whether it takes 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. The first thing you should do is have water and food security for at least 3 months. And I've been saying this since the beginning of last year. The other thing I want to tell you to do is to become as independent of government and large corporations as you can. What does this mean? You need to be able to take care of all the things that you need from government and large corporations by yourself. And if you can do that, you will be able to stand as independent as you can. And then you can make a difference in society. So, getting back to people saying, when there's a smoke, there's a fire. I mean, some of the comments were just absolutely ridiculous. And then there's the people that absolutely get it. That when someone predicts something is going to happen on a date, you should have the intellect to think that this person is trying to manipulate your mind, because they have zero evidence for that thing happening on that day. What you can say is that I heard that people are planning to do X, Y, Z. Or I was in a meeting where this and that person said that they were going to do this and that. That is real intel. And then that person should do something about it. If they are concerned with what these people are saying, then they should be apprehended and this should be resolved chop chop. But you see, this hasn't happened because it actually has an alternative purpose, and you have fallen for it if you believe this narrative. So I hope I've made it patently clear that you should always be prepared for everything, anywhere, at any time. That you should not work according to a date. Because this is someone trying to subvert your actions. So what are you now going to do? Do nothing, and when that date arrives, you are going to prepare for something on that date. Or look out for something on that date. Don't be a fool. Don't be foolish. Raise your intellect by thinking differently, questioning things, and then actually trying to understand why someone would be sending out information like that. Now, I gather all information that I receive. Some I listen to, some I don't. Gathering information, there's nothing wrong with that. But spreading information you cannot confirm is absolutely ludicrous, and you are a part of the problem if you do that. So all of you that say that you gather the information, there's nothing wrong with gathering information and knowing things. But spreading information that you cannot confirm is absolutely horrible, and it needs to stop. It's something that needs to be rooted out in society, because juveniles do things like that. A grown adult will verify whether something is true, the same way that they will interrogate their child when their child has done something that seems unsavory or that they're unsure of. You will interrogate something until you find out what actually happened. Now, if you cannot do this with statements flying around on WhatsApp and on Telegram and on Facebook, then let the information end with you. I've said this many times before. I know there's many new subscribers to this channel. And as you make your way through the Question Everything series and the Moments in Time series, you'll understand what this channel is about and why this channel has grown to the level that it has, and why we are a community of people that are actually changing this country one person at a time, one day at a time. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon if you are interested in my perspective on history as well as the future. Thank you very much. Till the next video.